Today, cop out and say all you have to do is believe. Believe what, friend? Believe in Antichrist? That's what they're leading you to. If they teach a rapture theory, leading you straight to worship Antichrist, the first Messiah that comes. He's a fake. He's a false Messiah. That the earth was of old. In other words, there was an age before this standing out of the water, not as you read in Genesis chapter 1. After it became void, there was nothing standing out of the water, and God ordered the waters to hasten away after he destroyed that earth age, and it became habitable again. Well, isn't he talking about Noah's flood? No way, friend. No way. God totally, completely destroyed every being in the kaboom. I'll document that in the next lecture. Verse 6. Whereby the world that then was, being overflowed with water, perished. Do you know what perished means? Everything of that age perished. Through Noah's flood, many people lived through it. I do not believe myself that the flood was worldwide, but that it simply covered the place where the Nephilim had impregnated the daughters of Adam, trying to prevent the birth of Christ, a Satan's attack. Genesis chapter 6, it's written. Anyone can read it that doesn't willingly wish to be ignorant. And God destroyed those hybrids, whereby the line through Noah was perfect, and the Christ child could come of woman. All of them, though, in the kaboom, that's to say, in the world that was, perished. That means there were no more. 7. But the heavens and the earth which are now. Do you think Noah's flood destroyed the heaven that was? Well, that's what it's saying here. The heaven was destroyed. Naturally, Noah's flood did not destroy the heaven, but the kaboom did. But it was the heaven age that was destroyed. It's still the same heaven. It's still the same earth. Now, we come to the second. But the heavens and the earth which are now, that's to say the second earth age and the second heavenly age, by the same word, what word? God's word. By the same word are kept in store, reserved unto fire against the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men. What does this perdition mean?